Hi, and welcome back to Talk of the Town. Recently returned from a summer of touring, Cranford Hollow is back in the Lowcountry and will be performing three shows on October 16th and 17th at the Big Bamboo. Here to tell us more of what we can expect, John Cranford.
Hey,
John,
Sandy, thanks for having us down.
Love having you back.
Yeah.
So I saw you before you left for the summer. You went, I think, towards the west, right?
We did about 26 days out on the road, starting in June.
Yeah.
Through July.
And so fun.
And did Colorado, New Mexico, Kansas, Mississippi, Tennessee.
Did they just welcome you with open arms? I mean, was it great?
Colorado has definitely been a market that we've been trying to build gradually. We started out there last winter and did some a run of shows out there and are returning, trying to get out there about every 4 to 6 months.
Yeah, nice. So let's talk about the new album.
Yeah,
Spanish Moss and Smoke. Different than the last two?
It's sort of an approach back to the first record we did. We did it at the same studio called Retrophonic Studios in St. Augustine, Florida. And we wanted it to have a really good representation of sort of what we sound like live. Mm-hmm. The record we did on Hilton Head, the last one, the self-titled Cranford Hollow with Greg Critchley, it was really produced, it was really big. Greg did an awesome job. He's a very talented guy, but we kind of almost simplified everything mm-hmm. on this one.
Okay.
So it's a little bit more about the songwriting and about the band's actual performance and doing these live takes and sort of really getting the energy and communicating that, what we do on stage, like into a record.
How did you guys fund it?
We funded it through Indiegogo, through all kinds of people here in the Lowcountry and as well all over
How'd
the U.S.
Out?
And
was
even
that a...
even in Norway we had people
wow.
contributing to it. So we ended up raising about $18,000.
Terrific.
And that pays for all of the mixing, mastering, the recording time, studio time, the engineer, you know, the production of the actual physical copy of the CD.
Right.
And then sort of leaves us with a nice little nest egg. You know, in case we need new tires on the van or you know, the radiator blows out,
exactly.
you know, something like that. We
kind
of wanted to have a little safeguard for the road and if anything would happen out there.
So when are you going to release this new CD?
The record will be hopefully at my door October 9th, and we'll have it in all of our contributors for Indiegogo. We'll get a mailed copy to
nice.
Them as fast as we can get it to the post office. And then generally for the public, the first copies will be available October 16th at the Big Bamboo.
Wonderful. And so you'll be touring Spanish Moss and Smoke?
We will be. We're going to go immediately after the CD release show. We're going to go up to the Midwest, actually to my hometown, Eau Claire, Wisconsin.
Okay.
As well as some stops in Chicago, Dayton, Ohio. Still working out some scheduling for the Madison-Milwaukee area. But primarily, it's a nice deal for me. I haven't been home or played at home in quite a while, maybe 5-6 years.
Yeah, nice.
So it's a great opportunity for the guys to come up and see where I'm from. And we're going to be playing at a historic state theater up there. And everybody's excited up in Eau Claire. We're really excited
that
about that
really
show.
That is really exciting. That's terrific. So let's talk about the Big Bamboo and the show and you know, how people get tickets and what they're going to see.
We're going to do two nights with three shows. The first show, Thursday night, is going to be more of an acoustic performance, similar to what the Jazz Corner does. It's going to be a sit-down dinner service. Your ticket will include your dinner and your drinks and all three shows, admissions, as well as a copy of the new record and a little media pack for all the people that want to spend the $69 to come see the acoustic show. And get the dinner. Then that evening, we're going to sort of have an open jam, playing our stuff, but bringing down guys like Jesse Watkins and John Ruxton and Martin Lesh and Will Snyder and Joe Vickers and John Wilkins, all these local guys that we play with and try to have them down. And then Friday night, we're going to do all three records sort of intermingled, but just straight through performance of every original song that we've written, which is, you know, somewhere now over 30, 35 songs. So that'll be a neat show to sort of get away from the covers and just really showcase our material.
Wonderful. Quickly, your favorite track on Spanish Moss and Smoke?
We're really excited about Savannah, which is where the tagline Spanish Moss and Smokes comes from. Yeah. It's sort of a historical piece written about the city of Savannah and all of that.
So excited for you.
And thank you so much.
I hope the album is just crackers on wonder. I'm so excited for you.
Thanks a lot.
Thank you, John.
Thanks for having us down.
And we'll be right back with Talk of the Town.